Okay, so now let's move on to Slimmer story number two. Miguel Masigan, yeah. This is circa 2013. Okay, but I actually met Miguel around 2012. I was always with someone, but we weren't in a relationship. We were just business partners, though the guy seemed to be insinuating, especially around other people otherwise. Yet his presence was so strong and it was hard to resist when I see him at the gym. So I thought that maybe we had a connection. With my business partner. Somehow I got close with Miguel. I knew he had a girlfriend, so I knew my limits. I knew where I stand. I mean, I could want him, but not really to be with him. He has really inspired me a lot creatively because he was a professional model before entering med school. So he inspired me to pursue fashion styling and knowing the business of fashion. Further, when I attended the Philippine Fashion Week 2013, which he was part of. Harry Styles and Taylor Swift. Awesome Israel Mega Mall. Because of the sound of the tone of his message, and most probably he's from the gym. He said that Miguel doesn't want me and that I'm just seeing everything as an illusion. I am so fed up of people prying into my feelings and saying what the other person feels. Well, in fact, the other person isn't talking at all. So not caring anymore if Miguel will hate me, I went ahead and messaged all his friends, really nasty stuff, since no one's gonna defend me or clarify that anonymous messenger's claim. So as expected, he got mad and threatened to sue me for my posts.
Oh.
messages. Oh my god, the text line is burning. Oh, yeah. So from Yan Lapel Padlan, that's the manager of Slimmer's World Metamon. Bakit hindi yung jowa ni Miguel kinuha mo para sa video na yan? Princess Legaspi, the ex of the ex of Miguel, the one who I knew who's going to the gym with him. Ang kapal na mukha mo, hindi ka magugustuhan ng boyfriend ko. Pabuhi ka na, hindi ka pa magaling sa kama. Alright, ouch. Pity ram of Megamon. Okay. Nagli-live-in si Miguel at Princess sa Makati. May kondo sila. The anonymous DM on Instagram. Nakakahiya ka! Di ka magugustuhan ni Miguel! And of course, the man of the hour says, I will sue you for your posts. Alright guys, so my takeaway from this experience is that, let me just say, the video that Yen was referring was the, I don't know, I think it's not already on the internet, because I deleted my Playhouse account. That was my business before MSR. Yeah, MSR, okay. So, I got him for Playhouse because we had to do a video before for Narol Saramhe. And it was really a change of script that I ended up being the love team of Miguel on that. So, for me, I guess even though the video is unavailable, I don't even have a copy of that because that was circa 2013. But it gave me the experience how it is to be a leading lady. Oh my gosh, perfect, diba? At least once in my life, I've experienced to be a leading lady on the camera, right? So for me, I guess that was that's my takeaway from being with him. But on a personal level, on a deep level, actually, I had less expectations from him than with Mark, with guy number one, because I mean, Miguel is even younger than me. He was still pursuing med school. I mean, you know, the guy has a dream, you know, and for me, I was in my 30s, and I was actually just pursuing my business, you know, so I really didn't have any expectations, maybe just respect. I just do not know why some people or most people that I've encountered cannot give respect. But sometimes it's just all that I expect there. So really, the bottom line is the takeaway that I just have is that I was able to experience how it is to be a leading lady. And that's it. I mean, I could not, have anything more to say, but maybe on my creativity level. On my creative level, yeah, aside from fashion, I was also able to write a lot of songs because of the experience. So, that's what I'm going to show you with the video.
Calling on my soulmate, don't be worried. Calling on my soulmate, don't be worried. but ain't you one? You got tonight, you got tonight, you got tonight, but ain't you one?